Hello, staff, students, and faculty. Thank you for tuning in to Haskell News. I'm Krista Katrin.
And I'm Kyle Griggs. Our top story, Chris Redman was inaugurated as Haskell's new president this month. The inauguration took place on Friday, October 7th in the auditorium. Many were on hand to welcome and congratulate Redmond, including Chickasaw Tribal Governor Bill Onatabi and KU Chancellor Bernadette Gray-Little. The oath was given by Larry Echohawk.
Haskell librarian Beverly Fortner was deployed earlier this month to Iraq. Here's Kyle Griggs for more on the story.
Haskell librarian Beverly Fortner was deployed to Iraq this month. Before she left, an honorary ceremony was performed at this year's Welcome Pack powwow. Many were in attendance, including her son and husband. Ms. Fortner knew she could be deployed at any time.
Here, I know that some people have been going on their third deployment, their fourth deployment. This is only my second deployment. I just moved here from Arizona in January of 2010. So prior to Kansas Guard, I was Arizona Guard. And total time, I've been in for 17 years. So getting close to my retirement.
Her son, Ricky Barkowski, said he was overall accepting of the situation.
Well, first and foremost, I'm very proud of her. You know, she's doing something that, I mean, there are a lot of people who have been deployed, but her case is a little bit unique because she's a mother. She's an older woman, you know, so it's harder for her to just kind of pick up and go. So I'd say I'm very proud of her for that, but I'm also scared, to be honest.
Ms. Fortner plans on returning back to Haskell after her year-long deployment. For Haskell News, this is Kyle Griggs. Haskell played host to Hirosutka, Japan, the sister city of Lawrence, Kansas, which came to the museum where the Haskell Intertribal Club performed dances for them. The visitors had a translator who explained everything to them that was going on, and the group later went on a campus tour of Haskell.
Lawrence's fifth annual Zombie Walk took place downtown. Many Haskell students, including the Stories in Motion Film Club, participated. A record number of over 800 zombies turned out for the event that raises money for the Lawrence Humane Society. Haskell celebrated their 2011 homecoming on October 8th. Dozens of students and staff participated in Haskell Pride Week, and many alumni were in town to celebrate their reunion. Will Riding In of the United Pueblo Council and Rochelle Chi of the Navajo Diné Club were crowned King and Queen for this year's ceremony. Haskell's football team fell short to Quincy University and collected their seventh loss with a 3-34 game score. Haskell started off on top, but by second quarter struggled to come back to win. On the brighter side, after 26 years, 80s alumni are back in town to celebrate their reunion. Alumni scrimmages and dances took place throughout the weekend, but nothing turned out as great as the reunion itself. Over 300 people were in attendance, including alumni and even recent Haskell students. Beaded goods and blankets, as well as many miscellaneous items, were raffled at the reunion. Nay Pinto Johnson, Lori LaCour, Jenny James, and Teresa Crank were the ladies in charge of the reunion. Without them and their 1 year of hard work, the reunion would not have been possible.
Okay. And with sports, here's Jamie Scott.
The cross country season is underway. Here's Ashley Ignacio and Aisha Peo with the story.
The women's 5K cross country Haskell invitation took place homecoming weekend. The event was held on a windy Saturday morning at Billy Mills Trail. The first runner to cross the line was Katie Mona of Emporia State. Haskell's women's team had seven runners. The top runner, Talisa Butters, finished fourth with a time of 19 minutes, 46.47 seconds, helping the team place fourth overall. The next home meet will be the MCA. AAC conference on November 5th.
Following the women's 5K race was the men's 8-kilometer. Haskell placed 7th out of 8 teams, with Haskell's top runners placing in the top 20. Thomas Zuni placed 7th with a time of 27.17, and Brandon Wallace placed 17th with a time of 28.1. Daniel Toomey of Park University dominated the men's race with a time of 24.59, winning by over a minute. Haskell will host the MCAC National Qualifying Meet November 5th.
Basketball season is about to start. Here's the coach and a few players talking about the upcoming season.
This year, we're just putting icing on the cake, and we're going to see what happens. I truly believe we're going to turn a lot of heads, not only at Haskell, but within the conference, within the Lawrence community, and ultimately all over the United States across our reservations and through our Indian people, we're gonna put Haskell on the map, and that's one of my goals.
Sky's the limit. I feel like we should go to the national tournament, hands down. We have all the talent. We have the confidence. I just feel like we're ready.
Hopefully, the beginning part of the season, just try to build and get our team better, ready for conference play, and then hopefully win the conference and then make it to the national tournament.
That's it for Haskell News. I'm Kyle Griggs.
And I'm Krista Katrin.
And we'll leave you with some homecoming parade footage.
Onward Haskell.
Thank you.